At John Horn High School this year, we're continuing with restorative practices with a focus on relational practices. This is specific to teachers and anyone involved with students on a daily basis. We are making a big focus on building relationships and sustaining those relationships, which includes being intentional about greeting your kids at the door and then having positive interactions between students at the first 90 seconds of each class.
Up in our offices, we've now changed the name from the Discipline Office to the Student Success Center. We've also incorporated our Student Success Team, the entire team, up there into our offices with our new construction that has been taking place. Our focused opportunities that come about in regards to repairing relationships has brought forth more than just the principal and the student within to the office itself. It's also brought in the person who's had the most harm caused to them, hence the teacher who writes the referral. We've been able to repair those relationships on a steady basis between student and teacher, getting the student back into the classroom, affording that child more instructional time.
6 years ago, a small group of teachers and I and a very supportive administration put together a plan so that we could be consistently competitive and successful in this UIL Academics program. I passionately believe in the program because it really helps kids build skills that prepare them for college and career beyond what is offered in the core curriculum. As a result of all of this, we achieved many of our goals in our five-year plan in under 3 years, so we've had to raise our goals even higher, which is a great position to be in. And we've had kids go to state every single year since we put this plan in place. We have a dedicated group of people and administrators supporting these efforts, and we're trying to build a program that encourages even more to get involved so that these valuable future career building skills can be available to more great kids.
A program that we're really excited about in the high schools that we've recently rolled out is Mental Health Awareness for Educators. These short online lessons allow educators to learn more about mental health issues and how they present in the classroom. The more people we have working with these students, the better the outcome for everybody. We can care for these kids, take care of them in and outside of the classroom, and give them a better chance for student success. We have crisis counselors and at-risk coordinators going into our discipline placements to work with kids and lead restorative circles so they can work on what the root issues of those discipline issues are.
Here at North Mesquite, we have always had security measures in place, such as SROs on campus. One of the main things that we feel like help keep our campus secure is when students are all in dress code, because it's very obvious when someone's on campus that doesn't belong if they are not in standardized dress. A couple of things that we've added this year is we do have the red phone near the front office that when guests or visitors come in, they pick up the phone and make a phone call to the front office and give us a little bit of information about why they're here, and then we allow them in to the campus. We also have continued with our Raptor system. Someone comes on campus and they need to go anywhere in the building, then we do run them through the Raptor system. So we know who is in the building, and they have a name tag that if anybody runs into them in the building, they know that they've been screened. A couple of things specifically for our campus, we've added some fencing in certain areas. Our campus is pretty open, and so we've taken some wrought iron fencing in different areas and kind of closed that in where it's a little bit more difficult to get into different parts of the building.
Community service here in West Mesquite is really important because we like to be a part of the community we live in.
Here at West Mesquite High School, we do lots of community service, not only individually, but also in programs with other programs. For example, here in ROTC, we do lots of community service projects. We do the Christmas cheer party, the veterans breakfast, and the honor flight. We do lots of that, and I think it's very important to set that example so other kids can follow us and they can see what we're all about here at West Mesquite.